Hello everyone, my name is Sujit Jha and this video is about preparing you for the person interview, the last hurdle in any recruitment process. All of us look for our dream job and every job, especially for a fresher, starts with one online aptitude test combined with technical questions. Once you clear that, your name is shortlisted for the further processes. Once your name is shortlisted, you may go for group discussion, you may go for jam. And the final one is the personal interview. If you clear it, you get your job. If you don't clear it, you get rejected. So my recommendation is, please master this process of cracking and a personal interview. So shall I start? Okay. Now, why companies conduct interview? Why an employer conducts an interview? If army people come to conduct an interview, they will first run on physical stamina test. Why? Because a person who cannot sustain physical stamina cannot be employed with an army, because in army career you may have to face some hardships sometimes, and unless you have the physical stamina to bear with it, perhaps you will not be able to get along well. So they will run this test. If I am looking for a Sanskrit teacher, I will not hire a person who has done PhD in geography, because he may not be a suitable profile. So interviews are conducted not to find the most qualified person. Interviews are conducted to find the person who fits the job. So I have a job, I have a requirement, I will take a person who fits the job. So person fits the job, job fits the person, that's called perfect job. And that's why interviews are conducted. So when an employer is coming and discussing with you, he just wants to know, he doesn't want to know whether you're qualified, the smartest guy in the college or the smartest guy in the city, or you're the most handsome looking, most beautiful. No, no, no. The person's requirement is very simple. He has got a job. He wants the job to be delivered well. So he's looking for a person who will fit in that profile. And if you can convince me as an interviewee that yes, you have got everything that makes you a fit candidate for this job, you are in. Okay, now to understand more clearly, let's play a game. Okay, the game is very simple. I'll show you some profiles, some job profiles. Then I'll show you some skills, traits, attributes. Okay, combination. So there are 6 people applying for 5 jobs. Now you tell me which candidate will fit in what job. That you have to decide. Software developer, nursery teacher, administrator, receptionist, customer support. Now these are the traits. Okay, I'll show them all on the screen for you. And now we'll discuss it. For an example, a person who smiles a lot, point number one, smiles a lot, very pleasant personality. Do you think this person will fit in the profile of administrator? As an administrator, he will have to take a lot of tough decisions. He will have to handle a lot of difficult people and issues. He may be a good profile, but may not be necessarily suitable. Will you hire a person as a software developer if the person smiles a lot and has a very pleasant personality? No. You need a person who can develop programs. So perhaps for a software developer, point number 4 may be a more appropriate profile. May not love Sudoku, but has to be logical. Has to be logical, because when he develops a program, algorithm, he needs logical thinking. Correct? Now, one more thing I'll discuss with you on this. Point number 2, short-tempered, gets angry too fast. Perhaps that person is not employable in any of these jobs. Okay. Point number 1, smiles a lot, very pleasant personality. Point number 6, smiles a lot, very pleasant personality and good problem solver. As a customer support, as a receptionist, you don't need a person who just smiles. You need them to solve problems also, right? So, a person who has got traits of 1, and a person who has got traits of 6 will beat 1 in the competition. So every interviewer will keep on calculating that these are the key skills I am looking for in the candidate. This person has more skill sets, so this person will be in. The way you think and select these people in the profile, same way your employer also thinks about you in the interview. So keep thinking that. And customize your preparation for every interview. If you are going for a profile, going for a company, you must prepare, know the JD of the your JD, you know about the company, and you must prepare your interview answers according to that and pitch it well to promote yourself and crack the interview. If you are simply going and attending the interview, that is facing the interview. And that doesn't increase the probability of your success in the interview. So prepare. For the rest of your life, every time you face the interview, including me, we are supposed to prepare and then go for the interviews. Okay? Now there are many millions of jobs and millions of skill sets required. So which ones the employers look for more? Let me just list out for you. Okay, very quickly. Okay, qualities employers look for: attitude. Fantastic attitude means big probability of getting jobs. Wherever you apply, you may be selected. Very poor attitude, perhaps not employable anywhere. Okay, good communication skill. In today's MNC culture, global culture of work, it is becoming a key skill. Because if you are not able to communicate well, it doesn't work. And the higher you go on the ladder of success, the better the package, the better the communication skill required. Confidence. In communication skill, confidence. Okay. Dynamics changing every day. You must have confidence to take care of the job. Domain knowledge, very critical skill. If you don't know about a subject, perhaps you're not employable anywhere. Right? If I'm looking for a Montessori teacher, I need to know whether they have done any Montessori training. If they have not been trained Montessori, how will I hire them? Even if a driver, if the driver doesn't know how to change the gear, how to put the brake, and doesn't know anything about the car, do you think you'll be hiring a driver of that kind? Not really. Okay, so it's very, very critical skill. Problem solving, team spirit, leadership skill, general awareness. A lot of people have a doubt whether general awareness is very important. General awareness may not cost you the job. It may cost you life also in today's corona crisis. Okay, if you just go outside and interview today, and you go and shake hands with somebody, perhaps they may not like this idea, because this spreads. So this general awareness that there's a crisis which spreads this way will save you life, save you the interview. Or else you'll end up saying something very stupid in the interview. Maybe, you know, the population of Karnataka being 70 crores, we have to manage it. A very, very big mistake. So these are the skills required. I am going to shortlist 4 qualities on which you should be doing well if you're looking for a good job. And those are: how do you score on these parameters? You check your score. 4 skills will come here. You are supposed to score well on those 4 skill sets to become really good in employment. Okay? Number 1, attitude. Minimum score, 10 on 10. Can you score 5? If you are scoring 5 or below that, you are not employable. Forget it. Okay? Nobody hires you. If you are 10 on 10, even if you don't have great knowledge, you may be employable. Now, if you have 10 on 10 attitude, great attitude, and very good domain knowledge, you will get higher packages. If you have got great attitude, but domain knowledge is okay, you will get a middle level package. If your domain knowledge is low, but attitude is very good, means you want to learn, you want to perform, companies will give you the opportunity, they will train you, and then they'll see your performance. But you will be hired on a smaller package, lesser package. Communication skill, critical in MNC culture, experience for the job. Now, one difference I'll clarify very, very quickly. If you are going for a finance, HR, data analytics, any job which requires domain expertise more, domain expertise is very critical there. There you have to score minimum 7 plus out of 10. If you are going for a marketing profile, sales profile, your communication and persuasion skill is more critical. So if you score in communication, let's assume as a marketing profile, 8 plus, domain knowledge 6 plus, you are a good profile, they'll hire you. Now reverse it. You are going for a finance profile, domain knowledge 6, communication skill 8, there is a doubt in your selection. Change it. Domain knowledge 8, communication skill 6, for data analytics, finance, you are a very good candidate. So you have to understand that and then prepare accordingly. Experience. Every job requires that. If I am applying to your school as a teacher, you will always ask me whether you have taught earlier somewhere. If yes, I will have more credentials, more credibility to be selected. If I have not, what I will do, as a fresher, what you do, any internship which builds your experience towards the job, you can do that. Any management fest or competition or any responsibility which you carried to gain experience in that domain which makes you more qualified for the job, show that. Third, do some certifications to build up, add up to that experience of becoming more suitable for the job profile. If nothing is there, check in your career, check in your life, check in your studies. What are the things which you have done, which can be kind of experience for that job that you applied for? And if you get these things, if you are good in all these areas, you are perfect candidate. If your attitude is poor, forget it. If it's excellent, company will still give you chances. Okay? Now, if you want a better package and guaranteed employment, you must score very good on these parameters. Okay? If you're scoring low, please keep on increasing the score and make your employability higher. Now, at the end, before you conclude, everything is practice. You can't simply learn about a cycle kick in theory. You can't jump. If you jump, you'll simply fall down and the ball will just go in. So if you want to really become good, you'll have to practice whatever you discussed. So give yourself a score on all those four parameters, make a plan how to progress, and make your job guaranteed. So crack, ace the interview, not face the interview. Thank you.